Sticker. We used them to improve the look of our favorite skins, to cover up major scratches when we couldn't afford factory new, and sometimes we apply them on shitty skins to make them way more worth than they should be. The reason I'm making this video is this M4 Blood Tiger with a Kato 2014 LDLC sticker and minimal wear. When this video gets released, the sticker is about 1500 euro worth. I bet you can get it on some sites for less, maybe even for just 1000 euro, but let's stay at this price for now. We don't need to add up the price of the Blood Tiger, since it isn't really worth anything in comparison. But let's be generous and give it a boost to around 10 euro. So we have a 1500 euro sticker and a 10 euro gun. So if someone was there to offer you this aircraft for a price of 500 euro, you should instantly accept and be happy about your profit, right? Wrong! You should never do that. While this might be obvious to some people, I recently realized that it isn't the case for most players out there. This knife is what a poor soul offered my friend for his Blood Tiger. That guy might still think he made the deal of his life, getting a 1500 euro sticker for his 500 euro knife. But the sad reality is that stickers are far, far away from what they were worth before getting put onto a gun. And I can assure you, this is not an exception. My friend invests a lot on applied stickered guns and gets daily offers that overpay him crazy amounts. That's why I'm going to show you the basics that you need to know if you want to get started in this entire sticker business. We will talk about the best sticker positions for each gun, what to do and what not to do, and how you can avoid scamming yourself by overpaying for applied stickers. This video will cover the basics. We will go deeper another time. Stickers can be applied on 4 different locations on every gun. There can also be no more than 4 stickers on the same item. You can select to scratch your sticker. If you scratch enough, it will ask you if you want to get rid of your sticker completely. There's no way to undo the scratching. Scratch stickers are basically worthless, so please, never ever do that, even if it might look good on your gun. Here's an example of an AK Redline with an 800 euro sticker in best position. Sadly, it is a scratched one, which is why the seller got desperate enough to sell it for $25, even though it is just scratched once. You heard me saying it again, the best position everyone is talking about. Let me show you the best position for every gun really quick. You can skip to 415 if you don't care about them and just come back to this video if you ever want to look up a gun. The best sticker location is often, but not always, the one where the sticker is the biggest. And yes, the stickers can have different sizes depending where they are placed on the gun. The best sticker position is basically the most popular one. For example, you will see the best location for orbs mostly on the scope. Or actually, it will always be on the scope the best position for the orb. If you are going to buy skins that have applied stickers already, then please, don't get any that don't have their most expensive sticker in the best position. There will be collectors that would buy them anyway, but your odds are better of spending all your money into a jackpot than finding that one collector that is interested in a specific position. The same goes for some scratch stickers. For example, there's this one guy, Arrow, that I like to watch a lot. He's obsessed with scratch Katowice stickers, but when you invest, it's all about increasing your odds. So you want to have the widest field of customers possible and not focus yourself on exceptions. So let's get the first rules down to paper that you need to watch when thinking of getting applied stickers. First, get them in their best position. You can always use this video or the internet to look up where that would be for a certain gun. Second, don't buy scratched guns. And don't scratch your own guns, please. We will talk about the other rules once the people that skipped are back. See you in just a second. Okay, so now I know where the best position is, but how do I find out the price that I'm being offered is fair? You should check out Buff Market, you will find the link in the video description. All you need to do is go market, apply stickers, and look for the sticker that you got offered. We will look for the LDSC one, for our example with the Blood Tiger. We can find a minimal wear AK Blue Laminate for $60 with the applied sticker. The sticker is 100%, which means it isn't scratched at all. If we look closely, the LDSC is in the best position for the AK. But what exactly does that mean for us? Think of it like this. If I can buy one of these AKs for $60 with the applied sticker I want, unscratched and in best position, Then I could just buy it from here if someone wants me to pay him or trade more than that. Basically, you can always find your maximum you should be willing to pay by looking at offers in the internet and by comparing them. Buff Market is not the only website that can help you with that, but it's the biggest right now and the one I personally trust the most. I can buy a Field Tested Red Line with Navi Holo in best position for 330, so I won't buy it for anything more. I hope this is helping you not to lose money like the M9 Bayonet Doppler guy did. He lost around 450 euro by a trade that he himself offered. It's not that simple though. You also need to watch conditions. A factory new gun makes the sticker look way cleaner and will go for a slightly more price than a field tested one. Also, you might have noticed that I did not show the Bison or dual Berettas in the best positions part. That's for the simple reason that I don't want you to get those. You're looking at a small market already. The sticker market is even smaller, and the applied stickers market might be the smallest market in CS after the coins. You won't find the right people that could be interested in such a bad gun, even if it has expensive stickers. There are so few collectors that would actually consider buying it, you will probably just be stuck with it forever. So please, pass on guns that are not getting played as much and try your luck with more popular ones like the AK, Orb, M4 or even Deagle. One more thing guys, do not apply stickers to your vanilla guns. This craft was less than 10 cents back in the day. Now it's worth more than some cheap knives, but I won't ever be able to trade it. Don't be like me, be smart about your investments. Also, if you can't find a gun on Buff or another site, then I would go with this thumb rule. If it's factory new, best position, scratchless, one good sticker, I wouldn't pay more than 10% of the good sticker's original price. That's it for today. We will be talking more in depth about stickers in another video in the future. There's also a new investment guide and a guide on how to get value without spending any money I'm currently working on, so stay tuned for that. Thanks for watching and see you in another video.